obviously, playing in this event each year is just something that's great for the state of Indiana. It's great for all four schools and fan bases. So, you know, we're privileged to be part of it. And it's four teams out there, really well coached, competing like crazy. First game and second game, everybody's fighting for their programs, for their teammates, and for pride. So I'm proud of our guys for the resiliency. You know, they did a great start. They came out really aggressive, especially in the back boards, and we had to respond coming out of the media. These guys have done that, you know, pretty much all year. They asked them to do it, and they grit their teeth and they respond. So that was something we talked about, and they came out and we changed the mood of the game. Then we had guys step up. Obviously, Kamal gets two fouls, and it's a next man up, double clinch mindset. Rashford was just his motor. We need a lot of credit to him for what he's done with Fadi over the summer, his commitment to his teammates to train and be ready for moments like this, where you have to just go down there and fight and work. They have a really good team. Matt does a great job. And obviously, with Harms out, it's a different form, and so much respect for them. And I thought the guys played with the respect that Purdue deserves.
Questions?
Yeah.
You had 14 points today, and like Coach said, you know, with Kamar being, you know, blitzed on in the pick and roll and being defended really tightly, how are you able to score? It seemed like they weren't defending you in the mid-range at times, too. How are you able to score with Harms out?
Yeah, obviously Harms is a long guy, shot blocker, but obviously you got Kamar coming off pick and rolls. That requires a lot of attention from the other team, so I'm always getting him open. That's my first job. And then, Andre is a secondary receiver, so did a good job finding me today. He recognized that. All the guys coming off all screens recognized it. They were up pretty hard, so I was ready to be a secondary receiver. And be, yeah, that's it.
What about Anthony? You guys think they were 8-23 in the game. So you guys were fighting sort of everything you got, especially early on. Just, what went well in there, basically, just both defending him and just keeping the ball out of the course in general?
Yeah, it's not mindset. You know, he's a low down there. He's a prune. Much better shape, he's really skilled. I thought Bryce set it from early, just being physical without fouling and balling him around the basket. And then he throws it up and it's hard to get him off. You know, he's got a good feel for where the ball's gonna go. So Derek did an unbelievable job, and he was in just effort, trying to post, moving around, being a wall. I thought our ball pressure was good, so we couldn't get in there as much. It's something we had talked about in preparation for this.
Well, is Kamar feeling okay? He kind of walked off gingerly a couple times, which I know he sometimes does anyway, but I was just checking to see if, you know, physically he's feeling fine.
Yeah, he's fine.
What is it, you talked about balance on this team, I guess, what does it say that, you know, you've had such big wins the last two games without him scoring a lot? He's been doing other things, but not scoring the ball.
Yeah, I think it's a credit to him and his teammates. You know, this is a group that has a ton of trust and love for each other. And so, Kamar's a willing passer. He's going to make the right basketball play. They were really loaded up on him. So Bryce benefited some, nice cutters at the basket. He's willing to move the ball. You know, he trusts the rest of the group. And guys, you know, trust themselves. You know, you got to trust your work. You've got guys that live in the gym and put in the work. And they're ready for the moment. So to have, I think we had 16 assists and 21 made field goals. Turned it over too much in the first half, we had 8. And, you know, coming to 4 in the second half, but 16 to 21 is pretty good.
Just Aaron playing off of that, basically, with Kamar being out for a lot of the rest of the foul trouble, just some of you guys just had it because you just find guys on the shots. And, you know, he was being loaded up on, you know, what kind of you guys just go out to take advantage of that?
I think we just stuck to our offense. I mean, I think we just trusted our offense a little bit more. Try to focus on defense, so we focus on defense and it stops so we get our transition to run. But just trusting the offense and getting the ball once per size and making them guard for longer. We do that if we make them guard for longer. It'd be tougher to keep up with the pace of our cuts and stuff like that.
LaVall, I know defense is mainly effort, so it's hard to say what when you're trying very hard all the time. It's quite hard to say when you're better defensive than others. Can you rank this game defensively and how good were you guys on the defense?
Yeah, I thought we were pretty good, and not at the start, but the second, kind of the middle portion of the game, right? We played second quarter and third quarter. Then we got up, and you know, the, when you're down like that, you get a little more freedom to just let the ball fly. And so they made a couple threes, you know, and then we missed some switches. But I thought for the most part, the guys were locked in. Christian David comes right in the game, and, you know, gets a block on one and takes a charge on the other. Joe Tucker crushes the ball, and gets a deflection, gets a steal. So, you know, top four. About three-fourths of the game, we were pretty good. Bryce Gold's going to be running as soon as we get back, because he let him into three to get to 60. He let him into three to get to 60.
Yeah, so you had six assists today. And it, like I said before, you know, they were really blitzing the control, and they were doubling on drives, early help side. Having Bryce down low, how is he so, like, physical, and how is he able to finish off your passes down low?
You said how is he able to finish?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not him, so, I mean, but I don't know. Where his shoulders are?
Yeah, we're both from the same.
What you got connection?
Yeah.
You got connection.
Yeah, it's a DMV thing.
What kind of thing is
it? It's a DMV thing. DMV, where we're from.
You mentioned Derek earlier, just for the first time, how quick was he in what you see him do well, and also you mentioned Jordan being able to obviously use that stuff as switches on trade routes, and did that well. It seemed like he was able to guard further and post pretty well. What would you say about just the importance of each of those guys in the day?
Yeah, no, I thought, you know, Derek had I thought he had great minutes when he came in, especially on the defense end, just, you know, kind of subbing in and played some matchup ball with Williams. And he did a really good job making him catch away from the basket. Just physical and 7 feet tall. Second half, he did a heck of a job just running and not even letting him catch it. And so it was really good. He's moving a lot better, feeling a lot better. Ran the floor, got a layup on the run, pick and roll. So, you know, just good to see him moving like he started moving, you know, getting back to himself. Jordan was, you know, thought he had really solid minutes as well, especially late. He was the pressure and the ball. Defensively, he was locked in. And so he's grown a ton on that end of the court. And it's good to see him, you know, go out there against a team like this and have success.
Yeah, for LaVall and Aaron both, it looks like one of Purdue's late game tactics was to foul Aaron on purpose, sending him the line. I don't know that I've seen a Butler opponent, you know, try that before. I guess, was there any thought of taking Aaron out? And Aaron, how did you respond to that? That was, I'm not sure that you've seen that.
No, they used to foul Rose Jones, they used to foul Ron Norad. The Bulldogs step up in the game. So no doubt taking them out.
I can make free throws late game. Make free throws any time. They weren't following my early. So I guess they thought that it would work, that they used to come and foul me. But I'm confident if I'm working every day. So.
One more? Yeah. Dave?
Also for LaVall, I mean, Butler is 11-1, but I still sense that this, you know, this team is like, you know, amongst yourselves, have like still identified a lot of growth areas. I mean, watch some look at Butler's 11-1 record, think, man, you know, are they going to get any better? Is Butler going to get any better?
No, of course, that's, you know, honestly, you know, it sounds like coach speak. We don't talk a lot about winning and losing. We compete, we're a team. We're passionate about daily improvement. That's Butler. And so these guys do it. They go at each other in practice to get better, to get in the gym, to improve themselves, to get in film room with the coaches. We've got a lot. We still haven't put together 40 minutes. You know, we've had opportunities to see opponents, so we're still hungry and hunting for 40 minutes. But obviously, there's a lot of resistance when you go against good teams like Purdue. But they have more in them, and we're going to challenge them to get it out of them.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, everybody.